大家好, I'm Nathan Rich, aka 火锅大王. You know, a lot of people out there are inspirational to me. When I think about the positive attitude some people maintain even after the worst tragedies, I feel inspired to be more positive myself. Occasionally, I find a person who has had a tougher life than I have. I listen carefully to every detail and I grow from the experience. Everyone has something to offer me. But recently, I've encountered someone who inspired me to do better, much better. This is a person who inspired me to laugh.But also to feel depressed. I'm talking, of course, about China's saddest clown. You know, there are a plethora of different kinds of people out there, many of which join into a pattern when viewed from afar. But I don't want to get sidetracked into philosophy. Today is about one particular kind of person. I imagine myself sitting in a bar. I've been invited to some convention, and I'm taking a break. Tough month.I'll have a bourbon on the rocks and some deep thought, please. Some guy next to me gets talking to me. He's bored, I can sense. I give him only minimal answers, but it's enough for him to ascertain that I'm a lover of America and China. This sparks his interest more. Rather than ask questions about China or have a two-way conversation, he starts to tell me things about China. Okay, fine. Only problem is, he's wrong about what he's saying.What a strange experience this is for me. Someone yapping my ears off telling me about something which he has no idea about. This kind of story does happen to me on occasion. I used to get it with punk rock, then with IT, and now with China. All these experts come out of the woodworks with nothing compelling and no original points of view. Just willingness to explain to me their stupid ideas as if they're given to be true. Even that imaginary character is just a normal guy.I don't find him abhorrent or anything, just a little annoying when I'm trying to relax. But what if there was someone who actually was Chinese, but pretended not to be? No, hated the fact he was Chinese. And what if that person went around telling everyone just how sure he was about the failure of China over and over and over again? And how we should all fear and hate China. I've definitely thrown some shade on America, but don't get me wrong, I love America.It's got so many great qualities, and it deserves a place at the table for sure. I criticize it because it's center stage of the world and because it's wronged China before. But take a look at this guy telling the world to view his country as adversarial.
China can shoot down our satellites.
Oh my God, China can shoot down our satellites.
And the question, Stuart, you might want to ask is, who do we blame?
Who do we blame? Okay, that's a weird place to suddenly go from here. I assume we would blame China, or...
There's two people. Their last names are Bush and Obama. President Bush did not look at China as an adversary. President Obama did not want to protect us in space. President Trump, thank God, is changing this.
Wait, we blame previous American presidents and we praise Trump. Oh, okay. I see why Fox picked this guy up. All right.
You've got to be prepared because...If your adversary thinks that they can blind you, they can take out all your assets in the first half hour, they might be tempted to do a number of things.
Ugh, this guy's logic is so strange. He just literally said you need to be prepared for war even when you're not going to have one. You mean like by keeping up on weaponry? Isn't that the thing you're complaining about?
They might be tempted to do a number of things. So, for instance, invade Taiwan, take over big portions of India. Who knows what they're going to do?
Take over big portions of India? Are you crazy, dude? What precedent has ever been set to make you think China wants to take over India? Are you referring to a few border disputes that happened in the past? Have you ever tried to understand China's foreign policy point of view? Look at the historical precedent. China has had the opportunity to invade and conquer India.Unlike Britain, they did not take the country over. China has had the opportunity to invade and conquer Vietnam. Unlike the United States, they did not invade. And there's plenty of good arguments to be made that Vietnam is part of China. Still, they didn't invade. Why? There's no mystery here other than why are you pretending to think China cares about invading India? And honestly, I don't really care about satellite laser weapons, but let's just assume everything you're saying is true.China has laser beams that can shoot down satellites and America doesn't. Isn't that an argument for America to stop lagging behind on technology? Like by, I don't know, not banning 5G while the rest of the world moves forward? No? All right, well, how about this then? Build your own lasers, America, and maybe after that you can explain where the hell all the defense budget money is going. Can anyone spell corruption?
We always talk about what China can do to us. They can hack here and cyber attack there. I presume... we've got the same capability, but we just don't say anything. I mean, presumably?
Yeah, presumably we've got the same capabilities.
Wow, this guy just said one of the most revealing things ever seen on Fox. Yes, exactly. We keep talking about all these big bad things China can do to us. Well, in fact, we can do those things to them as well. And the precedent shows us that the United States is far more likely to attack another country than for another country to attack it. Far more likely.
We have standard missiles, and those can be used to shoot down satellites in space, but we need time to adapt those.
This clown just said we need time to adapt standard missiles to be able to shoot down satellites. You mean like negative 11 years? Because we've already used missiles to destroy a satellite back in 2008. Did you research any of this? Okay, wait. Maybe I'm just being a jerk. Maybe he was called in last minute and he's just making stuff up that sounds good. Normally, he's well-researched. Maybe normally he's spot on. Who is this guy? Here's literally just a random video from 2016.
Author of The Coming Collapse of China, and known for his grim outlook a bit on the country. Gordon, welcome back to the show.
Jesus, imagine being known as the guy with the grim outlook on something.
The Chinese economy is so fragile, you say, that it might not be able to get through another year. Let's talk about that. That statement really did shock me here, Gordon.
Yes, that's the point. It shocked you. But it's not true. But wait. What was the name of this guy's book again?
Author of The Coming Collapse of China.
Did she say The Coming Collapse of China? You mean the book published in 2001 that famously forecast the downfall of China in 2006? This is Gordon G. Chang, the guy who forecast China's downfall again in 2011, and then in 2012, and then in 2016, and again in 2017? Oh dear God, what a sad, sad clown. All right, look, let me just explain what's going on in plain terms and hope it's not too late for Mr. Chang. Gordon, you're half Scottish and half Chinese. Two distinct and interesting cultures. Your father is apparently from Jiangsu. Listen, dude, I know you grew up in America. I know you've been bombarded by facts and media about China since you were young. Everything you think you know about China seems so real to you. I get that. I get it. But try to understand me here. You missed several key points in your studies because you were biased. Now, I know. I've been accused of worse myself. Hell, everyone is biased. But you missed a lot, Gordon. You really missed a lot. When you read about the Long March, the period of time when the Red Army marched for a year across China, you understood it only from one angle. You read that they said they were attacking the KMT. And then you read that the real truth is that they were retreating. And then you realized that they were just retreating. And the whole thing was a scam. But you were wrong. This is the problem with people like you, Gordon. You're already sure that China's bad and scary and wrong. And you might feel even more personally about it because you're Chinese. But because you come at history from this angle, you only find the negative perspectives to be true. Take a moment to dispassionately think about the Long March again with me. The KMT had finally managed to surround communist forces in what could have been the end of the Civil War. However, the Red Army pushed out of the encirclement and fled. Yes, Gordon, they fled. But keep listening. Don't close that mind of yours just yet. You can't peacefully flee in a country run by the KMT if you're the Communist Party, can you? You must fight. And that's what they did. They fought and fought and fought. They took losses and wins. They fought until their charge out of encirclement became a battle charge around the country. By the time they finally stopped marching, they were almost all dead. But they turned that nightmarish year of battle and pain into a newer version of itself. And soon it was the most powerful entity in Asia. Just think about that, Gordon. Maybe that sounds scary to you, and maybe that sounds dangerous or incomplete. Hell, maybe you're right, Gordon. But there's one thing you should be getting from this story that you seem to ignore completely. It's the one thing no one who's biased against China ever seems to get, and it's this. A trade war is not as bad as the Long March. Some financial difficulties is not as bad as the Long March. All the problems you talk about and your endless hatred of China are nothing. You wonder why your predictions keep failing, Gordon, and I'm telling you exactly why. You keep thinking that the Chinese people will roll over and die at the first sign of trouble, but you just don't get it. You've been misled by foreign propaganda. They are some of the strongest people I've ever met. They aren't going anywhere. The future is bright ahead. And the sooner you start looking at all the facts, not just the ones that support your media-induced delusions, the sooner you'll be able to make predictions that come true. Because you're discounting the Chinese spirit. Until then, you'll be endlessly confused as to why things never turn out how you think they will. Until then, you'll be China's saddest clown. Thanks, everyone. 谢谢.